Welcome to the Great Exodus series. God's plan of rescue for his children. Let my people go, the path to Mount Zion. My name is Michael. I'm the founder of Triple Grace and the Righteous Path Movement Foundation. And today our topic is unity. If you stay alone and fight for your life alone, you have it much more difficult than if you are in a community. Now, how much more should we Christians who are called by our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ to come together in brotherly love should form units? Why don't you start today and establish a community of true believers in your house or in your neighborhood or in any meeting place as an association or whatever? But do something, gather the people together. You have friends who are also true believers? Fantastic. Use them, bring them together. Build a community of love and righteousness in your house, in your neighborhood. And then come together every day. Read the Bible, get empowered, get teaching from different people. And when you are empowered and the Holy Spirit is with you, then go out every day into your neighborhood and lift up the needy, the nameless and faceless. And by being an example, you will win the people for the heavenly kingdom. Not by preaching them into their faces and forcing them, but by showing forth an example of love and righteousness. Through your community, if you call it a society of the rose, if you call it an assembly of love and righteousness, or whatever you call it, but step forward and come together in a community of true and faithful believers of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And come together every day. Empower one another. Share resources one another. Support one another. And then when you have all this Holy Spirit inside you, you go out and show your light to the world. And then the people will see your example. And they see, oh, these people have totally changed from what they were before. And then they will come and ask you, can we join too? And then you welcome them. And you grow and you grow. And if you have more than 50 members in your community, then you establish a second one. Because 50 is the maximum number that you can still decide together. And in such a community, everybody should be equal. Even the two elders who will lead them will be equal with the others. They only have the mandate of leadership, but not of elevation. So bring them together. You can do that in your house. Bring true followers of the past, true followers of Jesus Christ, together in a loving community. You can start that right now, because we are called to brotherly love into unity. And if you are then in unity together, we can solve the problem of one another. We can solve the problems of people in our neighborhood. And we can shine forth the light and the love of the Father for all to see. We are called into unity. So start today. Call right now your friends and say, why do we start a community? Why are we not coming together? Why are we not assisting one another in our way with the Lord? I have heard something good, some great news from Michael from Triple Grace. Why are we not doing that right now and come together? And if you have questions, we can call Michael anytime or reach him through the email. No problem. But let us come together in love, unity and support and build communities in our neighborhood. And by doing so, showing forth an example, and through that example, we will win souls for the heavenly kingdom. And by doing that, we will fulfill our destiny and purpose on earth. As the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ said, go forth into the nation and make disciples. But not by shouting at them, not by arguing with them, not by doing baptism in public fountains, not like that, but by showing an example of love and righteousness in your neighborhood and by changing your lifestyle. Then the people will say, oh yes, I knew these people from before, but they have changed so much. And now they are so happy and so content. Let them ask them how they did that. And so that way you bring the people to Christ by example. In the same way as our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ did it, by example, and not by forcing them, not by showing a comedy on a public place and to make Christianity a laughingstock. No, by showing forth an example, by showing forth the love of our Father, God Almighty, into our neighborhoods. And everybody can do that. Stop today what you're doing. Take the phone. Call your best friends who are also true believers and tell them, from now on, we will make a community together. And we assemble in my house. And we come together, we speak about the Lord, we speak about the Bible, we get teachings, and we get empowered through the Holy Spirit. And then we go forth every day to show forth the love of the Father to the needy, nameless, and faceless. It does not always have to be with money. It can also be some volunteer work, can do some help in some other ways for the elderly. There are no limits to what you can do in love towards your neighborhood. And by doing so, you will set an example. So what you do right now is to leave everything else and call your friends and create a community of love and righteousness. If you have any question how to do that, please contact me at triplegrace55@gmail.com. I'm always there for you. I hope you understand that to come into unity is very, very important for all true believers, and especially now when the sealed tribulation will start and the disasters and calamities will increase, then we have to stay together and we have to help one another. And this is your call forward now to do that. So do it right away. Thank you that you have listened to this topic today. May God bless you and your family abundantly, and I hope I will see you again for the next topic in our Great Exodus series. Have a blessed day. Maranatha.